Every death that occurs from an asbestos exposure could be prevented.
Don't be fooled. There is a connection.
Everything just ties together.
I don't know what I can do.
It's hard to describe what ADAO has been in my life. I certainly can't imagine it without ADAO.
We've come a long way, and I'm really proud of ADAO. Keep me
in your heart. Good afternoon again. As Linda said, and with a great segue, I'm going to talk to you briefly. How many of you have got your brains overflowing now and you think you're ready to go? Not many of you. Good.
Wow.
But I'm not going to take long. We're going to talk a little bit about identifying asbestos dangers in the home. And for those of you who might have read my bio in the program and seem to be a little confused, the bio in the program is my paying job. And what you see there on the screen is my non-paying job, serving as Managing Director of the Environmental Information Association. Frankly, if you're going to talk about where to identify asbestos in your home, you'd need look no further than the card that you've been handed this afternoon, which ADAO has put together, which very succinctly identifies for you all of the potential locations of asbestos-containing materials in your home. You've got an outside or exterior view, and you also have an interior view. And for those of you who look down these and get a little worried and a little scared about all the places that asbestos may exist in your home, you should be. We should all be very respectful of the potential for asbestos-containing materials in and around us, and we should work hard to make sure that we do not create exposures because of those. So we've got, and I will not go through all these because you've got the card in front of you, but I think that the folks at ADAO and their colleagues have done a great job of presenting these to you here. Let's talk a little bit about the basics of asbestos. And these are very basic and very elementary, but I think it's important that we review them as we talk about asbestos in the home. First of all, yes, we've all learned today that asbestos is a naturally occurring fibrous mineral. It's the breathing of asbestos that can lead to the cancers, including mesothelioma. And it's all about preventing airborne fibers, because if we do that, we effectively prevent disease. So let's looking through and kind of focusing in on the big items or the places that we might have more common asbestos-containing materials in homes and even around us, maybe in our workplaces. First, I would point you to popcorn or textured ceilings. This is essentially just a textured paint. Anybody here have popcorn ceilings in their home? We've got a few hands. How about in your workplace? How about the last time you stayed in a Holiday Inn? Yeah, all the hands go up now. We call this, in our business, we call these the Holiday Inn ceilings. Don't we, Tom? The Holiday Inn ceilings. Popcorn ceilings. So, what's the name of the game with these ceilings, as you might imagine? Don't disturb them. Leave them in place. Another common use of asbestos on the exterior of homes is asbestos siding and shingles, often called transite shingles as well, which was a trade name. And what's the name of the game with this material if we have it on our homes? Don't disturb it. Flooring products are very, very common. And in fact, those of us involved in the asbestos industry know that we look specifically for 9-inch by 9-inch tiles, because the age of those generally say to us we've got our greatest chance of finding asbestos in those tiles. But that doesn't mean they're the only ones that have asbestos. We certainly find asbestos in 12-inch by 12-inch tiles as well, and in sheet flooring products as well. So in flooring products, we're looking here at vinyl tile. It's not only the tile we're concerned about, it, but it's also the mastic used to apply these materials, these tiles, to the subfloor, whether that be a concrete or whether that be a wood floor. I cannot tell you the number of homes and buildings that I've been in where floor tile has been pulled up only to find a contractor who comes behind and says, well, before I can put the new floor down, I had to get a good smooth surface, so I sanded down the mastic to make sure that I had a good surface and created a huge cleanup problem and a huge exposure and asbestos mess just by doing that. Another common product we're going to see in our homes is boiler and tank insulation. This is a great example of some that's in particularly bad condition. I hope we don't face any of that in our homes. And certainly pipe insulation. Now this is a very common type of insulation that you might see in your homes as well, which is the corrugated type insulation. If you see this, if you have this in your home, I can guarantee you 100% that you've got asbestos-containing insulation in that product right there. And once again, don't disturb it. Gasketing materials in wood-burning stoves, in boilers, and things of that nature. Specifically on the doors of these, we might find asbestos-containing rope gaskets. And I've seen way too many times where homeowners say, you know, I think I need to replace that gasket. I'm going to pull out the old one and put a new one in. And hopefully today, in most places they go, they're not going to find an asbestos-containing replacement gasket, but what they're pulling out probably is. And then, of course, and we've talked about this one today, boy, if we haven't driven the point home today about vermiculite attic insulation, you're not taking anything away with you. But we've got the zonalite attic insulation, and the slide on the lower right I wanted to show you because it's a great contrast between a typical fiberglass and the vermiculite attic insulation, so you can see the difference in what they look like. If you've got the pink fiberglass in your attic, no worries for you. If you've got the zonalite, you do have some worries. Once again, leave it alone. So what do you do if you have asbestos in your home? Do not disturb it. If you have any of these suspect asbestos-containing materials and the age of your home or your workplace is such that you think they might be asbestos-containing, I cannot stress to you enough, leave the materials alone. I'm not going to talk to you about HEPA-filtered vacuum cleaners. I'm not going to talk to you about wetting materials down or working them with some kind of moisture to keep fiber levels down. I'm going to tell you, please do not disturb these materials. The other thing we can do is to make sure it stays in good condition. I've been in a number of homes where we've got the pipe insulation, like that slide in the middle, in a basement right next to the washing machine, and it's a great place to hang clothes to dry as they come out. We don't want to put them in sweaters in the dryer. We'll just hang them to dry, and they hang them right on the insulation. That's called disturbing asbestos-containing material, and I've just said, please do not disturb it. So hanging things on asbestos-containing insulation is not a good thing, and is certainly a great pathway to exposure. And if possible, we can limit access. If it's feasible and maybe necessary because of the condition of the material, that boiler insulation I showed you earlier would be a great example of, you know, let's limit access to that area of the basement, keep folks away from there so that we're not exposing ourselves or our loved ones to asbestos fibers. If, in fact, you get to a point where you are planning a renovation or you're planning some kind of maintenance work that requires disturbance of that material, please, please, please do not try to do it yourself. Please hire a licensed, qualified asbestos abatement contractor. And I'm going to talk a little bit more about that in just a moment. Don'ts. Don't dust. Don't sweep. Don't vacuum debris that may contain asbestos. We had a presenter earlier who talked about the vermiculite attic insulation and the test results from a study that was done in sweeping, in vacuuming, in working that material, even damp or wet, and we still had significant exposures. Don't sand, scrape, or drill holes in asbestos materials. Now, asbestos-containing floor tile is a great example of a material that is really not likely to release asbestos fibers and is not likely to create an exposure concern until someone decides to get the bright idea of drilling through it, or sanding it, or cutting it, something of that nature. And please, don't use abrasive pads to strip wax from your flooring. It's in pretty good shape. Let's keep it that way. What to do? Have I impressed the point to you? Leave it alone, please. If you feel the need to hire a consultant or a contractor because you do are planning a renovation or some kind of maintenance activity that's going to disturb the asbestos, I want you to know that the federal government has established required training for all asbestos professionals. And in fact, the states have then picked up here, and every state in the nation licenses asbestos professionals. So there really is no reason that any of us should not be able to hire a well-qualified and reputable asbestos abatement contractor. So ask for copies of licenses, ask for copies of the training certificates from workers and supervisors involved with these firms, and certainly, as with any kind of work we like to have done in our homes, let's ask for references as well. Or, if you feel the need to, just call us at the Environmental Information Association. We would be delighted to help you. We will direct you to members of ours that are qualified, licensed asbestos professionals as well. I'll call you back. And if, in fact, I haven't driven it home yet, please leave it alone. Linda has asked me if I would spend a moment to drive home the message of who the Environmental Information Association is. Our association is a membership organization of professionals involved in the asbestos abatement industry. We go further than asbestos into areas of lead paint and other environmental contaminants, mercury, PCBs, mold, underground tanks as well, and indoor air quality concerns. But really the thing that founded our organization in 1983 and the thing that really drives most of our work today still continues to be asbestos. And our mission is all about collecting, generating, and disseminating information about asbestos-containing materials and other environmental hazards in buildings and facilities throughout our nation. We can always use your help as well. So anytime you have an item of interest you think needs to be disseminated, boy, let's work together and make sure it gets out to people. We've been honored and pleased to work with ADAO and kind of to serve as a technical resource to make sure that when Linda has an opportunity to address folks on Capitol Hill, that the words and the message she delivers are also technically correct as well as passionately correct. And we're delighted to have done that, and we will continue to do it. Thanks.
That's terrific.
But thanks for coming, and thanks for making this the most successful conference thus far.
Keep me in your heart for a while.